juice, and you could see the influence started to move over. But that little place is holding it down.
Oh, so, shit.
Why don't you guys bring in the amazing cast, introduce all the amazing actors?
Yeah, it's time to bring in the cast, everybody. Come on in.
Oh, my
in.
God. I found it.
Hey, I don't know about you guys, but I already started.
Hi, everybody.
This looks like the most Mexican Loteria card.
I was going to say earlier in Tech Check, I was like, get ready for the Latino party. Plus TJ. What's up, TJ?
Yes, thank you so much. Hey, you guys, the show was so fun watching it, like sitting and watching it. It was so amazing. I'm so proud of everyone. It was so great.
Yeah, you did a great job, Thomas.
Oh, I appreciate
that. You did a great job, brother.
Yeah, you did so good. I was just watching.
Salute to season two. Salute to season two. Salute to the raising money for a great cause.
Hey.
Let's do this. Ah, Julissa, just in time.
I want to stop. She got it.
Let's do this.
Let's
do this.
You're so cute.
Mírense a los ojos. Mírense a los ojos.
Hey, why don't you guys tell everybody that charity that we're raising money for today as we do this table as well.
Yeah, we're so excited. First of all, thank you to everybody who's on here, George, all of our cast, everyone who supports. So Proyecto Pastoral is an organization in Boyle Heights that we got to visit with both our cast and our writers. Shout out to our amazing writers. In the past year and a half, we got to go check them out. And it was just incredible. The work that they do in the community is off the charts. They have a homeless shelter that supports so many immigrant folks who come into East LA and are looking for work and are hardworking, and they help support that. They have a daycare center that helps support essential workers in the community. A lot of our little mamacitas, tias, primas, primos and tios y papas who go out into the community, who honestly are really helping keep LA going. They're essential workers. They can't be home with their kids, so Proyecto shows up and takes care of those kids for them. And
that's
they
so
are
cool.
Helping to provide groceries, helping with rent, all of the money that they need to support them. Sadly, because of COVID-19, they had to cancel two fundraisers and haven't been able to raise the funds they need to keep this going. And so we had been already talking to them before coronavirus hit. We were already kind of working on something, but once this happened, we kind of all hustle to try to figure out a way to support them and to raise some funds. So we're so grateful to Netflix, to everybody here for coming
to
our Proyecto. They are so excited. They are so happy, and they're so grateful to everyone. So y'all check out the link,
proyectoplaza.com,
Gentefied,
and go donate.
In every family, there's a patriarch. I like to call him Piernas. He's brought back. He's bringing back the tantarans all by himself. Can we show a little love to the patriarch of the family? To Joaquin. Joaquin, buen hecho.
Hey, Joaquin. Nuestro pap. ¿Cómo estás, Joaquin? Desde México, ¿no?
Desde México.
Yeah.
Great job, Joaquin. Felicidades.
Igualmente. Gracias.
Yeah.
A ver, pues, should we get started?
Who is he most like in everyone's family? Who is Joaquin most like? An uncle, a father, a brother?
Oh, my God.
Dad.
He's Pop. That's Daddy.
He's like our grandfather. He is our
grandfather. He's our grandfather for a lot of people, right? And the thing, sure. You know, nuestro abuelo for everybody.
Yeah, but he's like the cool abuelo because y'all don't, you know, we get to see the other side where he's like, come on, let's have a shot. What's wrong?
Oh, my God. Yo,
I know. He
yes.
could drink us under the table 100%.
And he's fine.
He was like making us all say a plate. We're like, okay, Joaquin, let's do this.
You know what is interesting about Joaquin, because everybody knows him with that big old man, the face and everything. And then you see him in this character being such a big teddy bear. And even people ask me in the street, is he mean? And I'm like, no. He's the most huggable person I even met in my life. I mean, you're going to
get... You won't remember your real name, but I'll hug you.
The problem is if you meet him before Narcos or after, that's really going to...
Definitely.
Cheers to Joaquin!
Joaquin!
Any reason.
For any reason, yeah. It doesn't matter.
This is sparkling water.
What are some of the things you guys are doing to get by the self-quarantine and this whole stay home issue with the COVID?
We're doing it now.
Kids, what have you guys been? How have you been getting through it?
We're all rewatching your shows, George.
Which, by the way, George has a stand-up special coming out very soon that we're all excited about.
Oh my God, I'm so pumped!
It'll be about all them mamadas that we all have to get put through. So I'm pretty excited about that.
Hey, what's the date?
June 30th.
That's it.
Yeah, June 30th. We'll do it for half. We'll do it for half was something I mentioned that got me in a little bit of trouble with the commander-in-chief and Secret Service allegedly came to my house and considered we'll do it for half a threat. And then I told him that I considered it an estimate because we're Latinos. Somebody to do it cheaper, go ahead. But to me, it's an estimate. That's just
allegedly.
Allegedly.
That's wild.
It's a great assembly of actors and comedians. Felipe, I've known for maybe 30 years. It's good to see Felipe out there in that thing with such
from
a
the Que Loco days.
Damn. From Que Loco.
Damn. Oh my God.
What is your favorite go-to meal, Felipe? Are you a vegetarian or vegan?
Vegan.
He's vegan, so he's the real thing. So, what's your favorite go-to vegan Mexican dish?
Enchiladas.
Yeah, good.
But actually, vegano, like vegan cheese.
Yeah, the vegan cheese, or sometimes I eat them with an estilo Suiza with lettuce.
Oh, great! So basically, that's the reason your rabbit is pretty happy, Felipe. When you show them, you know, your rabbit is like, "I'm so safe," you know. Hey, brother.
Felipe's a longtime supporter of Proyecto Pastoral. We found that out recently. We're like so incredible. He has a lot of love for them. And they mentioned your mamacita, like growing up, because you grew up in the neighborhood.
Yeah, my mom actually would go there like for the little juntas. And when I won Last Comic Standing, I donated to Father Greg Boyle and that place. Because that I think Proyecto Pastoral is one of the few women shelters in that area.
Yeah.
Wow. Awesome. Felipe has a big heart, even though he looks like he's always just gotten home. even when he gets up, he looks like he just got. What happened to you? I just got up. the love, you know, to the love of the actors, the love of your cast and stuff. Carlos, amazing as well. You know, like who's the more Mexican test? That was a great episode of who's the most Mexican.
That's true, man.
Yeah.
It was fun. So,
It's good to see all you guys. Amy, you look a little, Addie, you look a little very different. You look beautiful. I love how you have your hair.
Oh my God, thank you. I was waiting for someone to say something.
Se parece a su papá.
Oh, pues. Let me have this pad, damn.
Oh, pues, no.
You have it natural. I had to go get this shit done. Like, let me.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome, man. So you guys, you haven't seen each other during this break, or have you been in contact with each other?
No, we've seen each other.
Only like me, Annie, JJ, and Carlos. Carrie's actually back home in Louisiana.
We FaceTime.
No, yes, we do.
We all
stay in touch.
A lot of zooming.
That a lot of zooming, yeah, that's awesome.
I mean, it's great. We jump on Carlito's birthday. So.
It makes me proud to see such a beautiful cast, such a talented cast, such a diverse cast, and representing Latinos well. Shall we get into the virtual table read? That's what everybody's
doing. Let's do this.
Let's do it.
All right.
A ver, pues.
Hey, my first
and I even wore my Jessica necklace, y'all.
Yes, wait, I wore my Lydia earring.
How do you have that necklace?
One time I did a table read, my first table read ever.
The show got canceled after the table read.
Oh my God.
Wow.
Felipe, hop off. Like, never mind, no season two. All right, let's do this. I'm going to be reading the stage directions. Oh, but for anybody that's watching that doesn't know what the hell a table read is, I guess I'll just really quickly explain that.
No table.
A table read is we're literally going to read the script out loud. I and then Linda will take over at some point reading the stage directions, which means like what we see, what the characters are doing. And then all the actors are going to jump in and they're going to read their lines from the script. So I'll be describing the setting of it and everything.
And I'll be sharing my talents with you.
Yes, and Joe's going to hop in and play with us. Some folks are going to read a couple parts, multiple parts, and we're going to keep it going. And, if we mess up, just, you know, roll with it.
Hey, if I mess up, don't recast me.
Laura.
Yes,
Laura.
I have a question.
Oh yes. Oh.
We should say what characters are we reading for or not?
No.
Yeah. No. We'll be reading the stage directions, so we'll be, the characters will be discussed.
We'll introduce everybody. All right. So with that said, I don't think, did I explain a table read right? I think I did.
Yeah, you did. You got it.
Marvin, just one question for Marvin and Linda. We're not auditioning, right? We're ready.
No, we got it. We got the part. Oh. I
just want to make sure.
No promises.
You guys, we are going to be reading Gentefied, episode 104, Unemployed as Fuck. It is written by Ariel Diaz. Woo-hoo! This was directed by America Ferreira.
Shout out to our writers and our directors.
All right, let's go ahead and get into it. Scene one, exterior, interior, various high-end restaurants on various days. Quick cuts to Cardi B's Bodak Yellow of a newly unemployed Chris making money moves. He straightens his tie, fixes his hair, practices power poses, and smiles an eager smile outside several fancy LA haunts. Several chefs shake their heads, hand back his resume. We see our boy's confidence dwindle after each rejection until interior high-end restaurant day, Chris sits across from Chef Michael.
Aren't you the guy that punched out Chef Austin?
Yeah.
Michael takes a big breath.
Somebody finally punched that dude in the face. You're my hero, my man.
You're welcome, but wait, does this mean you're hiring me?
No, not a chance, buddy. You're blacklisted, homie.
Wait, but I was just your hero.
Man. Well, some heroes are unemployed, like, Colin Kaepernick.
off Chris's dejected look, titles up, Gentefied.
Hey.
Interior Pop's house, kitchen, next day. Pop and Eric drink coffee. Chris enters and puts a bunch of bullshit in a bowl. Pop-Tarts, hot Cheetos, hot sauce, spray cheese, etc. Chris pours the contents of his bowl into a blender and pushes blend. He takes the jug, turns to leave.
You don't gotta do this, man.
It's just food.
Chris takes a swig, exits. Pop and Eric turn to each other. Pop and Eric turn to each other. Interior, no mommy's mommy's apartment, Jessica's room, day. In her swap meet chic room, Jessica sweetly kisses a sleeping Anna, abruptly waking her. Clearly not in her usual routine.
You wore me out last night.
Yeah. Well, good, because I wanted to show you how much I appreciated you, for the whole Ernesto-Yaneda thing.
Anna kisses Jessica's belly button when she gets a text from Pop. Anna holds up a finger. Wait, Anna glances at herself.
Hey, are you serious?
Text reads, family emergency, come now, with a burst of birthday balloon sent as a mistake because he's new to texting.
I have to go. There's like a birthday emergency of some sort.
Welcome to the Morales family, everyone. Are you coming back tonight?
After back-to-back nights? Girl, if I do a third, my mom will put my shit out on the streets and be real, babe. I mean, your roommates are probably sick of me by now.
No, that's not true. They love you.
We hear a pound through the wall. Then from off screen. Natalia, red kicks in after 4 days, baby girl. Interior, Pop's house, living room, day. Anna, out of breath, bursts into the house, Kramer style.
Okay. I got here as fast as I could. What's the emergency?
Well, estamos preocupados por Chris.
Yo, the other day, he used generic peanut butter. And get this, last night, I brought home non-organic nopales, and he looked at me in the eyeballs, I said nothing.
Are you kidding me? I mean, I don't have time for this bullshit.
Es que se ve muy triste, ¿no viste?
No. Look, Pop, I get it, but Chris, he's gonna be fine, okay? He's a big boy with a big, fat bank account. Okay, he can afford help, all right? Like therapy or Whole Foods. I mean, I give this a week, tops.
Behind her, Behind her, the toaster oven blows up in flames. Chris stands there catatonic with ash on his face. Cut to exterior Pop's house porch. Moments later, Anna and Eric stand outside to get away from the cloud of toaster oven smoke inside. Pop storms through the cousins.
No te dije, no. Ese cabrón necesita ayuda. Y tú no estás ayudando. Voy a tener que arreglar esto yo mismo. Old school.
Ooh, you're going to give him a chacada. Chacada.
No, no, no. Lo que él necesita, él necesita hierbas. ¿Eh? Voy a ir a la botánica.
A bruja? I mean, what are you going to do? Get the white devil out of him?
Let us know what time the exorcism is, viejito.
A vete la chingada, cabrón.
Anna and Eric chuckle. When Pop is gone, Anna turns to Eric.
Hey, you fool, what's going on with the whole shop eviction notice?
Chill, primita. Pop cashed Chris's check. I'll take care of the back rent. Buy us some time. It's like robbers can't kick us out. You know, we got rights, I think.
You follow up with Jessica on that? You know, she offered to help, so you don't go around with your fists in the air saying dumb shit like, we got rights, I think.
Anna, listen, I'm a man, okay? M-A-N, I'm a fucking man, all right? I'm a grown-ass man, and I got a fucking plan. And I'm going to tell you, I don't need your girlfriend at all.
Okay.
Exterior, First Street Day. Eric finds Jessica posting food drive flyers.
Oh, yeah, Jessica, I need your help.
Oh. Oh, you need my help, then.
Actually, I need help for a friend.
Mm-hmm. And I already told me about the shop's money problem.
Hey, okay, we're not having money problems, all right? Okay, fine. Okay, yes, we're having money problems, all right? Mm-hmm. We got money problems. We can't lose the shop. It's Pop's life. It's all that Vejito knows.
There's a pro bono lawyer in our office that can run circles around Rob. Call her. You're in for a long ride, so I suggest you read up on this shit. Check out these books.
An awkward beat. It's their first time alone, sans Anna.
Thanks for looking out for my family.
To love Anna, you gotta love her family.
There is a slow trust building here. Is this the first break?
It is. Yep. Time for a break. Great job, guys. Love it. Everybody, take a new shot. Hold up your sign, /Gentefied to donate. If you have questions, put them in the comments below, and we will get to them at the end. Right, George?
At the end of the table read, we'll do a couple more shots, I'm sure. We got to catch up to JJ. And then we will some people that are watching. You can ask questions of your favorite actors, and you can ask questions of the show. You can ask questions as fashion tips, hairstyling tips.
Flip it, JJ. JJ, flip it.
What? Oh.
God. I think George was right. We got to catch up to JJ, man.
For real.
Yeah, I catch up to JJ.
Ay, señor y padre santo, vamos.
Linda, you want to hop in on this one, do this next part?
Oh, sure. Okay, ready? Everybody ready?
That was so quick. That was the quickest intermission ever.
Sorry, y'all. You're going to be fast. Exterior, family yard, day. Close up on beautiful indigenous designs on brown skin.
I want Elsa!
You reveal Anna is painting kids' faces at a birthday party. The yard looks like Pinterest vomited all over it.
Hey, I mean, wouldn't you rather look like a real princess? A Mayan princess.
I want Elsa!
Jasmine runs away as Nayeli walks up with a slice of cake.
What's up with that kid?
Internalized racism.
Then Tim takes a seat at her station.
My turn.
Okay. What do you want? Spider-Man? Batman? Elsa?
Honestly, I'm kind of curious about what else you can do. I have been watching you all day, and I'm a big fan.
Yeah? Well, her girlfriend is a big fan, too.
Oh, really? Okay. Well, my boyfriend over there would also really appreciate Anna's word.
10 points to handsome gay chipster talking to family.
So, are Disney princesses your bread and butter, or what else you got?
No, I'm a real artist. I only do kid parties to pay rent.
Anna pulls out her sketchbook and shows Tim.
Holy shit. Anna, this is really good. Wow, your pattern designs are insane. You must get a lot of work. Tim.
Anna. Thanks. Yeah, I'm hella busy.
All right, well, listen, I'm sure you book up fast, but I would love to hire you for a party this weekend. It's for grown-ups and much more at your level.
Tim hands Anna his card.
Okay. Now, make me an Aztec prince.
Off Anna and Nayeli exchanging a look. Interior Lupus Botanica day. Pop enters and is stunned by the super modern minimalist aesthetic, i.e. House of Intuition. Lupus, 60s Mexican-American veterana, spiritual healer, enters from the back, hugs Pop.
Casimiro, finalmente viniste. Te he estado diciendo que vengas a ver las renovaciones.
Oh, señor Lupe, pues no sabía que las renovaciones significaba que te habías deshecho de todo.
Entonces, ¿qué te trae? ¿Cristal para Ana? ¿Manzanilla para Eric? ¿O estafiate para Chris?
Before Pop can respond, a white girl enters.
Ah, Lupe, I'm so sorry I'm late for my reading. Traffic's a fucking nightmare. When are you going to open up a shop in Venice?
Trust me, I'm trying, beautiful. Wait for me in the back.
The girl nods, goes to the back room, leaving Pop and Lupe.
¿Cómo está tienda? Uy, pues el negocio debe de estar bueno, Lupe.
Nothing official. If God is wants, so it will be it, chulo.
Tenía razón, ¿eh? Estafiate pa' Chris.
Lupe walks Pop to where a single jar of a tea rests. Pop takes the jar and looks at the price and puts the jar down.
¡Jole! ¡No, hombre! ¡No mames! ¿Triplicaste el precio?
The girl peeps her head out from the back to eavesdrop. Aware of the girl, Lupe speaks in English so she can hear.
Right, yes, because ethically sources tea leaves from deep the rainforest of Oaxaca.
The girl, seemingly satisfied with this, goes back inside.
Oh, pues, ¿sabes qué? Tal vez solo le recoja un poquito de cerveza con eso.
No seas tonto, Casimiro. Para ti es gratis.
Oh. Oiga, Lupe. ¿Y cómo te mantienes al día con todos estos cambios?
Pues a nadie le gusta el cambio, chulo. Pero si te alineas con él, encontrarás que el cambio puede ser bueno. ¿Entiendes lo que te estoy diciendo, verdad?
Lupe caresses Pop's arm. Is she hitting on him? Pop looks at the team nervous, ignoring the advance.
Chris siempre está hablando de cambio. Y todo esto ha valido la pena para ti, Lupe.
Bueno, pues puedo pagarle al abogado para obtener la ciudadanía de mi hermano. Estoy ayudando a mi nieto a pagar la universidad. Y ahorré para llevar a mis hermanas a un crucero esta Navidad. Así que no puedo quejarme.
This lands hard on the patriarch, Lupe notices.
Casimiro, está bien desear por ti, para ti mismo y para tu familia. La vida no se trata solamente de sobrevivir. Si trabajas de forma inteligente, puedes prosperar.
Pop looks up. He knows Lupe and Chris have a point. Exterior, a family yard later. Anna goes to Yolanda, 35, birthday kid's mom, at the food table.
Hey, Yolanda, I'm going to head out, so I just wanted to get my payment.
Of course, mi artista. $50 and some leftovers, right?
Yolanda, we agreed to 100.
Aww, I know. Oh, it's que, you know, times are tough, you know? We just canceled our Costco membership. You get it, right?
Just then, Jasmine drives by in a baby Escalade. Beep, beep. Tim's party gig seems kind of appealing just about now. Interior, Beatrice's apartment, evening. Beatrice sews clothing at her sewing machine while watching House of Flowers when Anna and Nayeli enter.
Hey!
Nayeli makes a beeline for her room to escape the coming argument. Beatriz picks up a box and hands it to Anna.
What's this?
No volviste a casa anoche otra vez. Así que asumí que te habías mudado.
Oh my God, does it really have to be this fucking dramatic, Ama?
I pack all your things, okay?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I don't know what I would have done without my sixth grade spelling bee trophy. Okay, fine. Look, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry, but look, I brought your favorito, Tres Leches.
Beatriz's face is stone serious. Tough crowd.
Do you have the rent money?
Not exactly, but I do have these amazing leftovers, tamales, arroz, fajitas.
You're joking.
Okay, this will feed us for at least a week, okay? Just put some tapatio on.
Unbelievable. You took a job that paid you in leftovers? Hold on.
Beatriz picks up her phone and makes a call.
Who are you calling?
Sí, hola, Mr. Landlord. Just wanted to let you know that I'm paying this month rent with Tres Leches. Bueno, ¿se encuentra el patrón? Ah, ¿qué cree? Señor Edison, this month I'm going to pay the electricity in installments of frijoles.
Okay, I get it.
Oh, do you want it in one large sack? Por supuesto que sí, no hay problema.
Fine, Ama. More Tres Leches for me.
Anna storms off to her room, shouting back. Interior Pop's house, living room. Oh, I'm sorry, break time.
Break.
All right, I'm gonna make y'all work.
You guys are cracking me up. Oh my God.
I love hearing it because it's not the same as like the final show.
Yeah.
So seeing lines that didn't make it is kind of cool.
Can someone explain Tres Leches to someone who might be watching who doesn't know Tres Leches? What Tres Leches?
Three different milks.
Tres Leches, it's a cake that's soaked in three types of milk.
Is it? Yeah, I really don't know.
Yeah, it's regular milk.
Condensed milk.
Condensed milk. And carnation.
I feel like everyone's taking a Mexican test right now. I did not know what the hell was in Tres Leches.
I know.
Actually, you can do it at home without even baking. It's you know? I know how to do it.
Yeah. Oh, do you? Why have you never made me one?
No, well, because you never come and see me. You know, you always forget about me, mija.
Damn.
Oh, yeah. You know, get a.
About to break up the band. So, proyectopersonal.com/Gentefied.
Linda. Linda, you wrote it wrong. Linda wrote the link wrong.
Just when you thought it was JJ.
At least you wrote it right.
Somebody took your phone.
There always been some JJ shit.
I'm going to stop with this. My apologies.
For everybody at home, really quick, please leave us questions in the comments. We want questions from the audience that we can answer at, during the Q&A. So if you have any questions, por favor, leave them in the comments. And while you're watching and while you're listening to the Table Read, por favor, go donate. Go leave a dollar.
Yay, please.
I know these are tough times, but everything helps. And if you got like, you know, if you're just rolling in dough, like you just for like wherever the money's coming from, we don't know. We won't ask.
No question.
You know?
Yeah, listen, $5, $1, $10, it all adds up and it makes a big difference, you guys. So please.
Yes, mija.
You know, in honor of your second season, in honor of me being honored to host you guys on this virtual Zoom, I'm going to donate $1,000 on behalf.
Whoa.
Hey, I'll be like George. Go donate.
It's a great cause. I've heard about it my whole life, and you know, it's a wonderful thing to do, and it's fun to do this to raise money for it. And
right on.
Everybody got it correct now.
Yeah,
I'm
so sorry.
my Linda, that's perfect.
No, it's fine.
Is that okay? No, was that not? Did I not do better?
All right. At least you
didn't put that biz.
Yeah. Remember, donate.
Pendejo.
Yeah, Q&A after, and we're still going. Shall we pick up page 14?
Yes, sir.
Donate that bingo money. Bingo's closed.
Okay. All right, you want me to jump back in, Linda?
Yeah, go for it.
All right, guys, let's do this. Let's get back in here. Scene number 14, interior, Pop's house, living room. Next day, Chris is wrapped in a Snuggie when Pop storms in, opening window blinds, letting the sun in. Chris hisses at the light.
Okay. Ya, esto es suficiente, órale.
vampiro. Vámonos, para arriba. Esto no es un motel. Levántate y ponte los pantalones. Vámonos.
I don't do pants anymore.
A ver. Tómate esto.
Hot pants. Chris, a mug of the hot tea from Lupe's.
What is it?
Brujería. Mírame. Escúchame, cabrón. Teníamos un acuerdo. Vives bajo este techo sin pagar mientras sigues persiguiendo tu sueño, huevón. Pero en este momento estás actuando como si no fueras pinche Chichi Chong.
Pop, it's Chich and Chong. It's two people.
Pues como sea, hombre, los dos son unos huevones y ya basta. Tienes que ayudar a la tienda, órale.
Pop, we tried this. Eric doesn't want me at the shop and nobody gets my superior taste palette.
Chris tries to put a juice box straw in his mouth, but misses.
Just, deja de poner excusas, don Sacazonapan. Si dices que eres un chef, vuelve a la cocina. ¿Quién te crees? ¿Eh? El príncipe de Idaho.
I don't know what I am anymore.
Hey, no te estoy preguntando.
Interior, Mama Fina's tacos, kitchen, later. Pop and Chris stand in the kitchen. Chris looks down like a kid dragged on an errand. Norma cooks in the background.
Bueno, a ver, Norma, escucha. Ella es la jefa, pero intenta divertirte, cabrón. No lo olvides, esto es lo que para lo que eres bueno. Solo mantente alejado de la licuadora.
Wait, where are you going?
¿Qué importa? Chichi. Dios mío. Debería haber traído tu chupón. Estaré atrás trabajando.
Pop goes to the back. Chris shuffles around awkwardly.
Oye, don't just stand there, baboso. Make yourself useful and do inventory. There's some carne asada and masa that goes bad today. We have to throw it away to make room for the next delivery. Go.
Wait. You're throwing away product?
What? You want to give our customers crazy vaca disease?
Time cut to Chris and Norma standing before a mound of frozen meat, masa, and other ingredients on the counter.
How long has this shop been throwing away unused food?
Was for a while now, since business has been slow.
Hey, can I try something?
Off of Chris having an aha moment, interior, Alucina's tacos, front of house, later. Eric enters with Crazy Dave. A handwritten sign on the door reads, Daily Special, Pot Pie, Limited Quantity.
What the hell's Pot Pie?
He looks around and sees customers eating tiny pies.
Yo, fool, these are fire! Let me get on that pot pie love. I'll do your marketing. Pop could be the next Patty LaBelle.
Crazy Dave is trying someone's pot pie. A little old Mexican lady smacks his hand away. Eric knows who's behind it.
LaBelle!
Crazy Dave is trying someone's pot pie. A little old Mexican lady smacks his hand away. Eric knows who's behind this.
Get a sample.
Interior, Mama Pina's kitchen, you continue as Eric enters. Chris and Norma chop onions side by side.
Chris, what the hell's going on out there?
Look, man, I don't want any trouble, okay? Pop begged me to come help.
Oh, begged you, huh? Something's wrong with the food. Something's wrong with the food I cook or what?
No, este way just made una carne asada pot pie from the masa that was going to go bad and called it pot pie. Get it? Pot pie?
Yeah.
Pop enters and quickly pulls Eric aside.
Wait. So the güero's cool now, huh? And I'm asked out because I didn't go to the pot pie convention?
Hey, cálmate.
Estaba tratando de sacarlo de la casa y mira, le hizo mucho bien.
What? He's over here fucking up the menu and shit. What part of Mexico are pot pies from anyways?
Hey, le salvó un chingo de dinero a la tienda hoy. ¿No puedes trabajar con tu primo, mijo?
I think Chris has it covered. Pop, you know what? I'm not good with putting beets in tacos. I'm out.
Eric storms out of the kitchen. Exterior, Mama Fina's back alley. Eric stands outside holding the flyer that Jessica gave him. He contemplates his future. We go to interior library. Moments later, Eric waits in line with law books. Next to him, Joaquin holds books as his mom talks to the librarian at the desk.
And what book you got, little man?
Diary of a Wimpy Kid. What's Unfuck Yourself about?
It's a highly sophisticated text. It's like, I can't read this name right now. For people without a dental plan.
We've been to here.
Say that name right? Nietzsche.
You got it.
Nietzsche.
All right, let me try one more time. Hold on, I want to keep
okay,
my job.
Okay, okay, go for it. Take two.
I'm going to keep my job.
It's like Nietzsche. Nietzsche. What was it?
Nietzsche.
Yeah, that's it.
Nietzsche.
Nietzsche. He's the Aztec
warrior. It's like the Aztec warrior.
We begin to hear Joaquin's mom talk with the librarian. Joaquin's mom talks with the librarian.
Okay.
Dígalo, gracias. Mijo, es que necesitan mi ID. Sabes que no tengo mis papeles. Lo siento, mijo. Es demasiado arriesgado.
Eric knows the reason. She's undocumented. He notices Joaquin is super bummed and interjects.
Excuse me. Can I check out the wimpy book with my card? Hey, listen, little homie. You finish this book, and if you and your mom bring them to Mama Fina's on South Reyes, I'll give you free tacos. Deal?
Deal.
As the boy leaves with his books, Eric beams. He feels good about himself, something he hasn't felt in a while. Interior Mama Fina's Tacos kitchen, day. Norma watches Chris chop over his shoulder, judging. He's getting a groove back in the kitchen, mumbles to himself how he still got it. His moment is short-lived when his dad Ernesto calls. Chris goes somewhere quiet to take the call.
Yeah.
Dad. Oh, George, hello? You're muted. Dad? George, hello? You're muted.
Hello?
Unmute your mic.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Oh, I'm getting up there. I'm catching you, Linda. Oh, so
come on, Dad. Talk to me.
Oh, let your dad talk. Don't interrupt your dad. I've been calling you for weeks with no response.
Okay. Oh, watch out. I've been busy. Okay.
Busy. That's funny, because when Pop called, he said that you were fired.
I wasn't fired. I quit. And I got a new job working at Pop's.
Oh, that's what you're doing with your education, huh? You're making tacos? After all the sacrifices I made, you end up in el barrio.
Okay, and you know what? Nice guilt trip, Dad. Look, if you want me out of Boyle Heights so bad, why don't you just pay me to go to cooking school in Paris then? Huh? I'll be on the first flight out of LAX. Hello? Sign up.
Hey, Eric, Ernesto hangs up on Chris. Seems like a no. So much for his fucking groove.
Hey, Master Chef, check this out.
You know what? I can't even right now, Norma, okay? I'm going to take a coffee break.
Norma.
I can't even.
Norma, what curled up is up his ass? He exits, she calls out.
Hey, Weddle, we don't get coffee breaks here. So much for the pinche help.
We go to a chipster coffee truck. Day, reeling from his combo with Dad, Chris waits in a long line, aggressively tapping his foot at the cashier. He's a ticking bomb of daddy issues. He spots Lydia, but she's with a dude. Full of adrenaline, Chris puffs his chest, and goes in hot.
Lydia, what's up?
Hey, Chris. Last time I saw you, you were getting dragged out of Manja.
So who's your friend? Hanging out? Getting coffee? Is this a date?
Alex, handsome, long Aslan ponytail, 30s, gets up to shake hands. He is much bigger than Chris. Chris brings Alex in for an aggressive bro handshake. Tries to intimidate him, fails.
Alex, I work with Lydia Elak.
Oh, you mean Lydia that's carrying my cousin's baby?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go to the bathroom.
Alex leaves. Alex leaves. Chris?
I don't like him.
Chris, you gotta tone down the aggro, bro.
Look, I'm sorry. My fucking dad doesn't get my dreams, and Eric's petty ass freaks out every time I'm near the shop.
All right. I'm going to stop you right there, because if this is a therapy session, I'm about to charge your ass.
Chris gets it. He changes the subject.
Oh, so what's up with Alex? With this Alex cat? Do you know he's taking a Mondo dump right now? Like, that's happening as we speak. He's taking a shit.
He's helping me with a job application to Stanford.
Stanford? You moving to Palo Alto? Alto? Oh, this isn't even a real city, okay? It's made up. What about Eric, though?
Are you kidding me right now? I have someone else's future to think about, not just mine.
Look, listen. I know you're pissed about the other night at Manja, maybe. That wasn't his fault. I fucked up. I take ownership.
Look, it's not just that. Eric has a lot of growing up to do. Come on, you know that. You live with him.
Yeah. Okay, I get it. Look, he's got his quirks. But I mean, listen, he's cut down on smoking 2 blunts a day. You know how hard that is? No. He filled his taxes this year. He even bought floss the other day. He hasn't used it, but it's only a matter of time, baby.
Lydia shakes her head.
That's cute. It's really cute. But you and I both know that floss won't raise a baby.
Listen, Lydia, I don't get a lot about him, but there's one thing I've never doubted, and that you're it for him. Like, I know that much for sure.
This resonates with Lydia. Alex comes back and Chris gets up.
Just think about what I said.
As he leaves, Chris punks Alex, who doesn't flinch. Lydia shakes her head and smiles.
Did you wash your hands?
I like the look Felipe came through with that ponytail.
I know.
With the ponytail, that was excellent.
Showing the hands.
So we're doing a little break.
Was George auditioning right now to be Chris's dad?
It was pretty dope. I'm not gonna lie.
It felt good. It felt right.
Can we acknowledge that Felipe has worn 3 hats and put his hair in a ponytail for all of his characters?
He's coming through his character.
The dedication is beautiful, Felipe.
It really is. It warms my heart. It warms my heart. Please, everybody, go donate.
ProyectoPastoral.org/Gentefied. Yeah. Let's get some money to the gente of Boyle Heights, the people who inspired all of these characters that you are watching right now from our communities. They all need our help. So if you can go donate, they would love it. We would love it. And we will be forever grateful. We're also celebrating season 2.
The last of my drink.
Get up.
Oh shit! Okay.
JJ also said we go back. He said Lydia's plural. I like that. Lydia's.
What happened?
Because I got a lot of personalities. That's why.
I'm curious. Do the other libraries drink during their thing? Are we the only ones who drank during the library?
But also when Carlos, or the character, says he's probably in there going to the bathroom, anything to make somebody different in somebody else's eyes. He's probably in there taking a huge dump right now while we're out here.
Think about that. Put that image in your head.
Put that in your head.
Oh, my God.
I love it.
And also, last thing, you guys, if more questions, leave us those questions for the Q&A. Porfis.
If you're going to leave questions, you have to donate. Even $1. Even a question,
hey.
Not donating.
This isn't a free Q&A.
I have a question.
We're Latino, nothing's free.
Wait, my mom over here, an LAUSD teacher, just said she's going to donate $50.
Oh. Yay!
Love that. It.
We're getting there.
TJ, are you guys gonna put the pot pie ingredients and recipe somewhere? Does that look
my
good?
My girlfriend really wants to make a pot pie. She's gonna pop pie. She's gonna figure out. She's gonna make a pot pie with carne asada y todo. And so
it look good.
All right, yeah, let's get back to this.
All right, we're almost done.
We'll put that up there. We'll also put the ingredients in the blender that Carlos blended with hot. Started with hot Cheetos, and then
we
we'll put
make
that.
The, oh my God! The unemployed Chris milkshake.
I like that. All right.
Okay.
Get back into it.
This is our last leg, right? Let's. I'll stay on it, right? Okay.
Oh, sure. Yeah.
Okay. Exterior. Mama Fina's Chris, coffee in hand, bumps into Anna carrying 2 large takeout bags of food.
Damn, you picking up dinner for the fam?
No, this is my lunch. Rough day.
Angle on Chris's coffee cup. Instead of his name says, none of your fucking business.
Oh, that. Long time. And my dad.
Look, why don't you come with me to this party tomorrow? There'll be hella white chicks.
Oh, great. My people. At last.
And it takes off.
Hey, you paid for that food, right? Right?
Interior Pop's house. Eric's room, night. Eric reads a book. He wears glasses, drinks tea, and smokes weed. He gets a text. It's from Lydia. It says, how are you? Hey, Eric sits straight up. He starts and stops the text several times. We see the three dots stop and go, stop and go, stop and go. Finally, we see good.
Fuck, good? That's all you got, pendejo?
She texts back, I'm glad. Eric, how are you? Lydia, good. Going through old pics of bonfire last summer. Thought of you. Eric smiles and takes a hit of his blunt when Pop opens the garage door abruptly. Eric waves away smoke, puts his blunt out. Pop ignores this. He knows his grandson is a pothead.
Okay, Pop, what's up? What's up? Oh, my bad. No, go ahead. Go ahead, Pop.
Tengo que hablar contigo de algo serio.
Okay, Pop. What's up?
Eric gets another Lydia text. I've been thinking about us.
Quiero que el güero nos acompañe en la tienda. Oficialmente. Como un compañero.
Eric's eyes are glued to his phone. What did he say?
Yeah, Pop. That's great. Wait, what? What? No, 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 no.
Just then, Eric gets another Lydia text. Never mind. Before he can respond, Pop grabs his phone and tosses it.
Hijo. Hijo. Escúchame. Esto es serio.
Okay, Vito. Let's lay it on me. Fast. Come on.
Tenemos que pensar en el futuro. Y especialmente tú.
You don't think I know that, Pop?
Tenemos que hacer algo o vamos a perderlo todo, ¿me entiendes? ¿Y para qué? El pinche orgullo. Tenemos a Chris con su título en negocios y él fue entrenado para ser un chef cabrón. Y ahora mismo él también nos necesita. Sería una estupidez que no se uniera a nosotros.
I get what you're saying. But he's not going to save the shop. He's going to change it. What are we going to change? We don't got to change for nobody. Pop, if it weren't for the rent hike, we'd be fine.
Sí, sí, pero nos aumentaron la renta. Tenemos que aceptar la realidad. ¿Sabes qué? La vida no tiene que ser solo para sobrevivir, mijito. Podemos prosperar.
Pop leaves. Eric's phone pings. He dives head first for it. Interior. Mama Fina's tacos next day. Eric is at the register. He sends Lydia a text. Good morning, rose emoji. She responds, heart eyes emoji. Before Eric can respond, Pancho interrupts.
Oh, wey. ¿Y mis tacos? Who are you texting, huevón?
I was actually texting your daughter back.
Oh, well, in that case, pues take your time. Mío, ya sabes que, pues de hecho, I'm not hungry. I have a mendiga tortota at the house, so, you know, actually, it's okay. But hey, don't fuck this up, eh, cabrón?
All right.
Chewy, who sits at the counter, interjects.
Hey, did she send you a serrano emoji?
Chewy winks.
Yo, little man, there's no way you finished those books already.
You said free tacos? I read them.
Well, if you read them, I bet you could pass the pop quiz, huh?
I could pass any quiz, mofo.
Okay, relax. Let me think. What does Greg's big brother, Rod, say to him when it's the first day of school?
He teases him because his mama bought him his school supplies.
Nice. Okay, but that's the first chapter. Next question. When Roderick
Norma?
Julissa?
Nice.
I've been coming up with the other people. I've been saying other people's lines. I don't know. Where are we?
You're doing great.
Wait, hold on. So
Forget him,
Mio.
Enjoy the tacos.
Yes. Gracias.
Norma leaves. Joaquin places his books on the counter.
Hey, you got other books I can borrow?
Seriously? Hell yeah. I mean, heck, yeah. Hold on, what I got here? Here's what I got. An autobiography by Malcolm X. Never too soon for that. Plato's The Republic. This one's a trip, man. Spoiler alert, everything's an illusion. You should know that right now. And finally, Count of Monte Cristo. The most gangster book you're ever gonna read, man. Betrayal, revenge, secrets, it's got it all.
Cool.
He takes the books and leaves.
And I see you back in a week.
Eric's phone pings. He looks. Peach emoji, tiger emoji. Tonight? He knows what that means. Eric does a dance and slaps the counter, scaring customers. Exterior, interior, Livia's apartment, night. Eric knocks. Livia opens the door. They stare at each other for a pregnant beat, pun intended. Then they attack each other's mouths and make out hard. Exterior, interior, warehouse, burning party, night. Chris carries a ton of crates full of Anna's art supplies.
Yo, I feel 100% used right now.
Oh my God, just be happy you got invited to a party. You're not at home watching K-Pops in your chonies.
Fair enough.
As they walk in, it's Cirque du Soleil meets the Rocky Horror Picture Show meets Fantasia. Vegas-worthy laser beams. Everyone's in costume, naked, or covered in glitter/leather.
Oh, this is weird.
Chris drops Anna's supply at a tent.
Okay, well, I'm going to go find someone to make out with. Peace.
Chris leaves. Anna sits to set up her space. She turns around to a loincloth in her face. It's Tim from the kids' party. He's dressed in full indigenous garb.
Anna! Woo! Welcome to decompression.
Wow, Tim, you really doubled down on that whole Aztec prince thing.
Isn't it glorious? Oh, listen, I'm going to Venmo you now because I just dropped a lot of acid and I probably won't remember later.
Anna gets the alert. Tim paid $600 for flame emoji, man emoji. Dude. Anna has a silent holy shit moment.
I'm sure you're used to getting tons of tips at other gigs, but burners don't believe in commodification. So I hope that was enough.
Yeah, that'll work.
Hey, we are all about gifting here, and you are my gift to the community.
Ooh, that sounds kind of problematic.
A man with a beer belly and goggles taps her shoulders.
Yes?
He stares at Anna. Anna looks to Tim, confused.
He wants you to paint his body, love.
Tim sees a butt-naked friend in only combat boots.
Ooh, combat boots. I gotta go.
Tim dances away. Anna looks at the $600 Venmo payment, then at nipple clamps.
Sit down.
Interior, warehouse, burning party, elsewhere, same. Meanwhile, Chris flirts with a white girl, from the same one from Lupe's Botanica.
What I'm saying is life isn't about doing. Life is about being.
I mean, that's a relief because... Yeah. I'm being unemployed.
White girl kisses Chris. She slips him ecstasy on her tongue. Interior, warehouse, burning party near the tent. Back to Anna. Quick cuts of Anna painting people's bodies and loving it. She's covered in glitter and paint. Someone passes Anna a joint. She takes a hit. Then we see the party through Anna's eyes. It's slower, moody, trippy. A blend of colors and shapes. It's magical. Cut to a hyper fast time lapse. We see the party through Chris's eyes, who's now rolling on ecstasy. The room spins. People dance and make out. Chris joins, smiles, dances in circles.
I'm being unemployed!
We intercut between Anna and Chris's trip, POV. We land on Chris, noticing a naked burner wearing a chef's hat. His trip takes a left turn. The scene becomes erratic. Chris screams on the dance floor. Chris takes off his clothes and climbs on an art installation. White girl and crowd cheer from the ground. As we pan up, Chris clings to his naked body onto the art. White girl yells from the ground.
The chef is coming.
And from her point of view, we see Chris's bare ass. We cut to interior Lydia's apartment. Eric and Lydia roll around in bed.
Oh shit, my bad. Yeah. it's gonna get good when I start scrolling on my desktop, thinking it's my laptop.
Yeah. Okay.
Let's go. Sure.
Here we go, baby.
So Eric and Lydia roll around in bed.
I miss your toffee brown skin and that nape of your neck and curves, baby.
Shut up and just do me again.
His eyes widened. Damn, okay. Cut to post-coitus. Eric goes in for a romantic kiss, and Lydia devours him again. Cut to post-coitus part two. They hold each other for a warm beat.
God, I missed you.
You see Lydia's contemplative face. Eric sits straight up.
What was that?
I think the baby just kicked.
Eric lays his head against her belly. Lydia watches him, torn and unsure of what the future holds with him. Eric gazes at the woman he loves and her pregnant belly. He thinks about the future, his responsibilities. He knows what he has to do. Cut to interior, No Mommy's Mommy's apartment in Jessica's room. Anna sneaks into bed with Jessica, who yawns. It's 5 a.m.
I go.
Babe, oh my God, it was so dope. There were lasers and banana hammocks. Oh my God, and Chris got fucking naked.
Come
here. Anna settles into Jessica's arms, closes her eyes, when her phone lights up with a rapid series of texts. Tim,
loved your work. I have a building and needs an incredible mural. Hey, can you do it for 2K?
Holy shit.
Anna responds. Woo, had so much fun. Can you do it for 3K?
Oh. Smiley face emoji.
She hits send and holds her breath. Tim texts back.
Done.
Just then, Jessica grabs Anna's phone and gently tosses it to the bottom of the bed.
What?
Gently tosses it to the bottom of the bed.
The ADD's kicking in.
Jessica?
Jessica?
I said it.
Oh, we didn't hear it.
There's so many parts, you guys. Give her a break.
Here we go. Stop fixing your family's problems.
Anna's eyes are wide open off that last text. We go to Boyle Heights at dawn, a gorgeous sunrise over the historic neighborhood the Morales family calls home. A rooster crows. Interior Pop's House kitchen, morning. Chris eats cereal, wears eyeliner, jewels on his face and boxers, his face glittery and a random ball patch in his hair. Eric enters wearing the same outfit from yesterday, his shirt inside out. Buttons done wrong. He pours himself cereal. He sits next to Chris, a long silence as they eat. Each looks at each other. No judgment, just an unspoken respect. And dare we say it, bro love?
Fun night?
You?
Eric nods, long silence.
Oh, you better mime it.
Milk it. Needs more milk.
Oh my God.
I was thinking you should join the shop. Like, officially.
Oh God, thank God. Yes.
They eat in silence, both accepting what they have to do next if they want any shot at their futures and being a family. End of episode 104. Thank you, guys.
Wow,
yay!
So fun.
That was amazing.
Let's hold them up one more time. You guys did a great job.